in DC circuit. It is the unit number 5, DC circuit is here. This is the syllabus of study of AC circuit. Also, we have to need study of DC circuit, because in this chapter we have need DC circuit only. Okay. Now, what is the difference between AC circuit and DC circuit? Because AC circuit always consists of alternating current. It is called as AC circuit, and DC circuit is also called as direct current circuit. This is the difference between AC circuit and DC circuit. Now, in DC circuit, we have to do classification of electrical network. It is very important. Then, next point is energy sources, like ideal practical voltage and ideal practical current sources. Okay. Now, these are the important in energy sources. Then, we have to need star delta converter with the help of series parallel combination. It is very important in DC circuit. Then, Kirchhoff voltage law. It is very important. Kirchhoff current law. It is very important. Then, mesh analysis. It is very important. It is also called as loop analysis. It is loop analysis. It is also called as mesh analysis. Then, superposition theorem. It is very important. And last one is the Thevenin's theorem. This is the syllabus of DC circuit. Okay. Now, first we have to explain classification of electrical network. And classification of electrical network, it will be classified into four types. Then first one is the linear element. Then second is non-linear element. Then active element, passive element. Then unilateral element and bilateral element. And last one is the time variant system, time invariant system. This is the classification of element. It will be depends on electrical network. And classification of element, it will be classified into four types. And these are the four types is here. Now, first we have to explain linear element and non-linear element. What is the definition of linear element and non-linear element? It is also called as linear network and non-linear network is here. Okay. Now, here, linear network and non-linear network. In linear network, it consists of parameters or elements like resistance, inductance and capacitance are always constant in linear network, and its change with respect to time, voltage and temperature is called as linear network. That means in linear network, using three parameters like resistance, inductance, capacitance, all are always constant, but changes with respect to time, voltage and temperature is called as linear network. And also in linear network, Ohm's law will be used in linear network. That means linear network is applicable for Ohm's law. This is called as linear network. Then non-linear network. Second definition is non-linear network. Okay. Now, a circuit whose parameter like resistance, inductance and capacitance change their value with respect to time, temperature and voltage is called as non-linear network. But Ohm's law is not applicable to the non-linear network, because Ohm's law, that is V is equal to IR. Then this parameter is constant in this network is called as linear network. Then Ohm's law is applicable to the linear network. But in non-linear network, Ohm's law is not applicable, because value of resistance, inductance and capacitance, the value are variable. and change with respect to time, temperature, voltage is called as non-linear network. And this is the difference between linear network and non-linear network. Okay, now this is the first point is here, but this is the graphical VI characteristics, and it will be find out which characteristics is linear or non-linear. Now here the element consists of linear, that is linear element. Then VI characteristics, this is the VI characteristics, it will be passes from one origin point, this is the straight line, and passing through origin point is called as linear element. Then this is the straight line passing through origin of the point, that is central point of the origin, is called as linear element. But the line does not passes through origin point is called as non-linear element. Then again this line does not passes to origin, then again that is non-linear. But here the straight line passing through origin, but at a certain time it will be bent, is here, that is fall. Then this type of element is called as non-linear element. Again the line are does not passes through origin, is here. Then this type of element is called as non-linear. Same here, straight line does not passing through origin is called as non-linear element. Then straight line does not passing through central origin is here. Then this type of element is called as non-linear. Then again curve line does not passes through central point or origin, that is origin is here, does not passes from origin point with respect to time is called as non-linear. Then again this is the straight line is here passing through origin, but at the end it will be bent. Okay, that is, this is the bent section is here. Then this type of element is called as non-linear element. Okay, now this is the first classification is linear element or non-linear element. Okay, now this is the difference between linear and non-linear, that is line passing through origin is called as linear, then line does not passing through origin is called as non-linear element. Okay, now this is the first classification is here. Then second, active network and passive network. What is the difference between active network and passive network? Then active network is defined as, it consists of voltage source and current source. Active network consists of voltage source and current source is called as active network. But in passive network, voltage source and current source are not present. Is called as passive. Okay, then example of active network is, it will be depends on voltage source, current source and battery, electric battery. These are the example of active network. The example of passive network like diode. This is the example of passive network. This is the difference between active network and passive network. This active network consists of voltage source and current source. It's called as active network. But passive network does not consist of voltage source and current source. It's called as passive. Okay, now this is the difference between active network and passive network. Okay, now we have explained with the help of example. Okay, then example is here, active voltage source is voltage source, current source and battery. These are the examples of active element. Then passive element examples like resistance, inductance, capacitance and diode. Okay, now these are the element is here and its value of resistance is greater than equal to 0. Then value of inductance greater than equal to 0. Then value of capacitance is greater than equal to 0. Okay, now here this is the circuit diagram is here. This is the voltage source. The voltage source is called as active element. Resistance is present here, that is called as passive. Okay, now this is the difference between active element and passive element. That is active element example like voltage source, current source and battery. Then passive element example like resistance, inductance and capacitance. Okay, now we have to need one diagram is here. That is we have to draw one diagram is here. Okay, now this is the fourth quadrant is here. This is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay, now first and third quadrant. Now first and third quadrant that is here. This first and third quadrant is called as passive element. Is called as passive element. And 2 and 4th quadrant is called as active element. Okay, now this is the important difference is here. That is 1st and 3rd quadrant is called as passive element and 2 and 4th quadrant is called as active element. Okay, now this is the difference between active and passive element. Okay, now here the positive slope is called as passive element and negative slope is called as active element. This is the important difference is here. It is passive element slope is positive, active element slope is negative. This is the difference between active and passive element. Okay, now here we have explained one example of active and passive element. Okay, now this is the passive element is here. Okay, now here resistance is connected here. Then formula for voltage is V is equal to I into R. Okay, now this is the voltage across resistance or voltage drop across resistance is V is equal to I R. Okay, now here we have to need this is the plus voltage plus current. Okay, now this is the minus voltage and minus current is here. Then rearrange equation for R. R is equal to V by I. Okay, that is we have considered resistor. Then R is equal to V by I. Then put first quadrant is plus V. That is we have considered first quadrant is here and plus I is equal to put plus I. Then we obtain resistance is equal to plus plus get cancel. Then R is equal to V by I is obtained. Okay. This is for first quadrant. Then we obtain second quadrant. That is V is equal to IR. Then R is equal to V by I. Okay. Then here put V is equal to minus V. Then put I is equal to minus I. Then minus minus get cancelled. Then obtain R is equal to V by I. Okay. That means all values are positive. That is this value get positive. And this value get positive. With respect to resistive element is called as passive element. That is the positive slope is called as passive element. Okay, now this is the example of passive element is here. That is operate in first quadrant and third quadrant is called as passive element. Okay, now we have to explain another example of active element. That is, this is the second example is here. It is active element. same procedure is here, that is a plus Vi plus I is here, then minus V is here, minus I is here. Okay, then R is equal to V by I. Then we have considered second quadrant is here, that is plus V, that is plus V, put minus I, that is here, that is minus I is here, then R is equal to minus V by I. Okay, then fourth quadrant is here, that is line is here, then for fourth quadrant R is equal to V by I, then V is equal to put minus V, okay, I is equal to put I plus, okay, then R is equal to octave minus V by I. Okay, that is we have considered resistive element, that is R is equal to minus V by I. That is we have considered for two quadrant operation is here, then octave R is equal to minus V by I. Then fourth quadrant we have considered, then octave R is equal to minus V by I. That means all values are negative, and negative slope is called as active element. That means two and fourth quadrant operation is called as active element. Okay, now this is the concept of active element and passive element. Okay, now this is the difference between active and passive element. Okay, now this is the second point is here, that is active and passive element. Okay, now we have to need next classification is bilateral network and unilateral network. Then bilateral network consists of VI characteristics and its behavior is same. That means bilateral network consists of VI characteristics, that is voltage and current characteristics, and its behavior is same, and it will be depends on direction of current, is called as bilateral network. That means the bilateral network is defined as its VI characteristics and its behavior is same with respect to direction of current through element, is called as bilateral network. Then unilateral network. The unilateral network consists of VI characteristics and behavior, and its behavior is depends on direction of current flowing through element, is called as unilateral network. Now this is the difference between bilateral network and unilateral network. Okay, now we have to explain with the help of example, that is bilateral network and unilateral network. Okay, now we have explained one example of bilateral network and unilateral network. Okay, now here example based on unilateral element and bilateral element. The examples of bilateral element like resistance, inductance and capacitance. The examples of unilateral like diode. Okay, now here we have explained first example for bilateral element. This is the example of bilateral element. Okay, now here V1, I1 is positive, positive is here. That is V1, I1, both values are positive here. But here minus I1 is here and minus V1 is here. Okay, then formula for Z is equal to V by I. Okay, now we have considered this circuit. Okay, so we have considered this circuit is here. Then Z is equal to V by I. Then we have considered Z1 impedance for this side. Then here V1, put V is equal to V1. Then put I is equal to I1. That is V1 by I1. This we obtain impedance in first quadrant is Z1 is equal to V1 by I1. Same for impedance Z2, that is Z is equal to V by I. Okay, now it is Z2 is equal to voltage is minus V1. Okay, and current is minus I1, is put here. Okay, then minus minus get cancelled. Then Z2 is equal to V1 by I1. That means both parameter is same here. That is both parameter is same here. That is Z1 is equal to V1 by I1 is here. And Z2 is equal to V1 by I1 is here. That means Z1 is equal to Z2. That is by means more than 1. That is by lateral element. That is both values of impedance are same is called as bilateral element. And both values of impedance is not same is called as unilateral element. That is in bilateral element. That is in bilateral element impedance is same. In bilateral element impedance is same, but unilateral impedance is different. This is the difference between unilateral and bilateral element. Okay, now here same example for bilateral. This is the another example of bilateral element is here. Okay, that is Z is equal to V by I. Then V is 4, put here. Current I is 4, put here. Then Z is equal to 1 ohm. Then here voltage is minus 4, current is minus 4. Then Z is equal to minus 4 upon minus 4. Then obtain impedance is 1 ohm, 1 ohm. That is both are same. Then this type of element is called as bilateral element. Okay, now this is the example of bilateral element. Okay, now we have to explain example of unilateral element. That is the impedance does not same. This is the example of unilateral element. Okay, now this is the voltage is 8 volt is given here. Then current is 4 ampere is given here. Then Z is equal to V by I. Then 8 by 4 is put here. That is 8, 4. Then obtain Z is equal to 2. That is obtain 2 ohm. Then here V is equal to minus 6 volt is here. Then I is equal to minus 4 is here. Then Z is equal to V by I. Then Z is equal to minus 6 by minus 4. That is minus minus get cancelled. Z is equal to 3 by 2 ohm. Then both impedances are different. That is first is 2 ohm and another is 3 by 2 ohm. That is 2 is not equal to 3 by 2. That is both impedance is not equal here. Then this type of element is called as unilateral. This is the difference between bilateral element and unilateral element. Okay, now this is the third classification of element. And last is the time variant system and time invariant system. Okay, now this is the last classification is time variant and time invariant. Then time variant system depends on time is called as time variant system, but time invariant system does not depends on time is called as time invariant system. In time variant VI characteristics changes, that is in time variant system VI characteristics changes is called as time variant system, but in time invariant system VI characteristics does not change is called as time invariant system. This is the difference between time variant system and time invariant system.